Ensuring your network can support new sites and expansions. Scaling your bandwidth to meet evolving connectivity needs. No matter what your organization's technology journey looks like, Spectrum Enterprise delivers solutions, services, and support like no other provider. So you can take the next step with confidence. Because helping you grow your business is part of what we do best. Visit enterprise.spectrum.com/iHeart to speak with a technology expert.
There are 13 folds that bring the American flag to the iconic shape of freedom. This summer, Folds of Honor and Budweiser celebrate 13 years of changing military and first responder lives together. Service never stops, and neither will we. So join me in raising a Budweiser to raise funds for Folds of Honor.
Enjoy responsibly. Anheuser-Busch Budweiser Lager Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to get through this thing called life.
Welcome to another episode of the Reset Yourself 22 podcast. Thank you all of you for tuning in every week and listening and getting back to me with comments and actually ideas for other shows. It means a lot to me. I am Jimmy Gonzalez and I'm your host. And today's episode is about the manipulation of energy. This episode may be a little weird for some, but here's a little secret. This will actually be one of my favorite topics because it is something that I tend to beat to death with my clients. Energy. Everything. Everything is energy. The power of life exists within us and around us. We are surrounded by energy. And although we cannot perceive them with our five senses, these energies really do affect us. In fact, one of these energies is life energy, or called qi in Chinese and prana in Sanskrit. The world we all know, the physical world of matter, is not only a world in which we move and interact. You see, your physical body may walk in the physical world, but there is another plane that we travel through. This level is interwoven within us and through our physical bodies, and it moves and interacts on an energetic level. Some of us find ourselves walking with one foot in both realms. This regular realm that most of us walk in, well, and then we have that weird spacey plane of energy that some of us, mainly the empaths, feel strongly around or in. You may think this is all hoodoo voodoo. Well, finally, science is showing us that everything is made of energy. It is the building blocks of all matter. The same energy that makes up your body is also the energy that makes up the cement and the 2x4s that build the house that you are currently living in or at work. Even your car, your phone, and this includes animals, trees, plants, etc. As I said, everything is made of energy, and it all vibrates the same. Everything is always flowing, moving. As for spiritually, we are immortal souls, that we experience the earth as spirits, and we use our physical energy bodies. Just as you drive your car, your body is a vessel of the soul. So we are spirit made of energy, and we vibrate. So when we resonate high, we connect with everything. When you're living a happy life, a positive life, a life that you are taking care of your body, your temple, you will see synchronicities happening, and it really is an amazing experience. Sadly for some things, Oh, here it comes. Here it comes. That's sound energy going by. Sadly, for some things line up so well that we begin to take these moments for granted. So you may know those people, maybe it's you, that just everything goes well. It's always working for you. Well, be thankful. Be thankful because there may be a day, you know, that things don't work out. And then before you know it, smooth sailing turns up into your ship crashing into the rocks. And then it is at that moment that you now become resentful of the world around you. We've all been at that point when we think everything is actually going too well. And then sadly, one thing happens. And now the shit has hit the fan. And everyone gets blamed for this. God gets blamed. And this includes everybody you've ever gone to school with. Your friends and your family. Everybody gets blamed for something that may have happened to you. And then the fingers begin to get pointed. So, how often have you heard the saying, count your blessings? I hear people say it often, and then people repeat the sayings, and then the moment it doesn't go exactly, how they wished life sucks as well, but nothing is going right. Well, here's the thing. The world will shit on you. The world shits on all of us. It happens. But is it really the world, or is it you? And then if it does, how do you react to it? Do you let it just roll off your shoulders? Yes, this shit. Or do you hold on to it? And some people will actually make it even bigger than what it was. So now they have big shit. So, 99 things go well and one doesn't. So we now harp on this one thing for hours, for days, for weeks. You must, and I mean this, you must be happy when things are good. And when things suck, understand and come to grips that life has its ups and downs. But by now, for most of us, we should be used to it. I mean, I'm 53. I've had my fair share of screw-ups. Things will screw up. But I ask of you, how many horrific things have happened to you, yet you are still here? Think about that. So many obstacles, so many doors have slammed in your face, but you are still here. You are listening to me. Why? Why are you still here today? Do not take any of your life for granted. I am sorry people have died in your life. I am sorry you have been robbed, you have been lied to, you have been cheated on, you have been betrayed, and I know you have been hurt. And I'm not saying that I expect you to just accept all of the abuse, or all of the embarrassment, or all of the bullying. But what I am saying is that these people vibrate low. They are douchebags. They resonate a miserable, dark energy. And these people, because of jealousy, envy, anger, and hatred, will target you. They will shoot daggers at your back. And sometimes, they don't even mean it. They just wish, well, they had what you had. And instead of working for it as hard as you did, they prefer to sit on their ass and envy you. You are shining and they want to blow out your light. They want to bring you down to their level. This is when you begin to feel like shit. And physically, things start to hurt. Headaches, backaches, and on and on. Mentally, you find yourself unsure about your life, about yourself. You may be even doubting yourself. Amazing what some real good, top-notch manipulation from douchebags can do for you. Because you see, it works. After a few years of the abuse, here's the thing. You begin to forget who you are. This is a reminder, and you know who I'm speaking to. To be careful who you call friend, who you have a relationship with, and who you let into your world. As you may wonder, many of my clients come to me because they no longer recognize themselves or no longer know who their reflection is in the mirror, simply because they have allowed someone to break them down, burst their bubble, and destroy their dreams. So now, I ask of you, do you really know who you are? not just your name and what you do for a living. Do you know who you are? Think back to a moment in your life that it all changed. Maybe it was after a shitty relationship, or it even could have been because of a supposed loved one, that looking back you realize they broke you. Don't be embarrassed. Don't feel foolish. I'm not judging you. I'm not picking on you. But I'm holding you accountable starting today. Think about it. Was there a time in your life that things were going a certain way, and it's almost as if you somehow got on another path? And then fast forward 3, 4, 5 years, and you're like, what happened to me? Who am I now? Why am I here? It does happen. Let me tell you about an amazing woman that inspired me. Basically, she's fascinating. To many athletes, the way they look upon Michael Jordan, because as you can imagine, Michael Jordan has inspired thousands of basketball players. For me, it's Dolores Cannon. She's such an amazing person, an amazing woman. She was a hypnotherapist, and she was a recognized pioneer in the field of past life regression. This lady specialized in the recovery of cataloging, lost knowledge. Her roots in hypnosis went back to the 1960s with her husband on a military base. And she specialized in past life therapy since the 1970s. The whole past life thing happened by accident. She was doing hypnosis, and all of a sudden she realized that it was getting a little bit deeper. And she, of course, began to take notes, like thousands of notes. And because of her many sessions, many sessions with clients, she experienced that we are energy, and that we are on this planet to manipulate energy. So what are you doing with the energy around you? Yes, I'm asking you, you. Let me simplify this with the simple concept of, let's just say, positive energy, something we all kind of have heard over and over. Positive thoughts can affect your surroundings and cause ripples in the ether of energy. It's like a boomerang. What you send out comes back to you with great power. When you send out positive vibrations that reflect your true emotions and feelings, positive events, people, opportunities, situations, everything, well, they come back. People tend to think of them as coincidences. But these things boomerang back at you. Wake up pissed off at the dog, the cat, your kids, your partner, and, well, vibrate low. Wake up in a shitty mood. Oh, my God. Breakfast sucks. Oh, my God. You look at yourself in the mirror. You're just like, oh, my God, I look like crap. I feel like crap. I'm crap. Everything hurts. My back hurts. Well, guess what? That's going to continue throughout the day. Well, unless, of course, you meet somebody who's positive and wonderful, who inspires you. But if not, you're going to be going down the drain. And here is the real magic behind this power. When I say positive or negative energy, you do not have to even open your mouth. This is where I throw in the cosmic consciousness connection. We are all connected. Remember, we are all vibrating. So want something in your life? Be clear and concise in your mind, in your heart, and be true as to exactly what you want. Not just walk around and say, I want $1 million. It's like, yeah, okay. Well, why? For what? How much exactly? And what bills? What bank are you putting it in? What's going to be your first deposit? What's going to be your first withdrawal? What's going to be your first purchase? I just did this last week, and actually manipulating energy, I was able to manifest a few opportunities that I did not actually even feel could be attainable. Ain't that crazy? So my conscious mind, you know, the chattering monkey, you know, just like many of you, just talks. But deep down inside, my spirit really wanted something. And my connection to my higher being opened all doors, and I received some amazing things. And for them, I am always, always, always eternally grateful. Ever have that thing just plop on your lap and you're like, wow, how did that happen? Well, I believe you asked and you received. Even when it's, how did that horrendous thing happen? Sometimes horrible things happen to us because we ask for them. And I know a lot of people are like, I don't ask for negative. Yeah, you do. It's not in the same words, but it's in the same energy. But the same applies, like I said, to negative emotions and thoughts, such as worry, anger, and hatred. Well, guess what? That boomerang will sooner or later catch up with you and return your negative emotions. It's just the way it is. It's a natural law. Then you're standing in the middle of a pile of shit. And again, now this is where you blame everyone else. It's like, no, my friend. You attracted this. Remember that every thought and action has consequences. The nature of this effect depends on the nature of the cause. The better the cause, the better the result. But if that cause is a negative thought or evil, the result will be negative or evil as well. It is therefore important to be careful with your thoughts, because they become words. Be careful with your words, because they become actions. Be careful what you do, because it becomes a habit. Watch your habits, because it becomes your character. Take care of your character, because it will become your destiny. Now, is the inner world real? And can we determine outer world things by our thoughts? Well, again, thank you, scientists. They say that the universe is expanding rapidly and that no one understands why. But when we become part of the creation and use these thoughts and feelings of our inner world, everything begins to make sense and change. Religion, yes, and science are even getting closer and closer. Who would have thought the line could have become so fine? As horrible as it may have been, remember the energy we had as a nation on September 12th, 2001? We were hurt and angry, but we became so united. I remember that there were statistics shared soon, within that month, that companies were selling out of American flags. Remember the ending of that month? It was like America was not fighting amongst itself about racism or anything. We were all proud Americans. It was nice. I remember that so many homes had flags. In fact, cars even had those stupid little flags propped up in their windows. It was very patriotic. And now, because of the drama in politics, we have become so sadly divided. Actually, on my street, I'm the only person that has a flag. I will never take my flag down. Actually, I just got a new one because the old one got old. So, of course, with everything that's going on, I feel worse than ever because people are allowing what's happening out there to control them. And I'm not saying to turn a blind eye, but I am saying the energy that you have can be changed by what's around you. So you can control what's in your head. You can control what's in your body, but you can't control what's out there. And when you start to let it seep in, it will change you. It will manipulate you, and your life will go to shit. People are actually judging families and friends because they chose to vote for so-and-so. Who would have thought that we would get to a point as a nation that we would bully each other because they voted for so-and-so? When did we become a nation of bullies? Who I vote for, or what party I follow, or even what god or goddess I pray to, is not and never been your business. These are very personal decisions, and I have always had friends from many different faiths and many different political parties, and I have always respected them. And in fact, been intrigued by their culture. Oh, I love to get into it and talk about stuff. And I'm not here to change anybody's mind, but I'm here to learn about other people's thoughts. And by doing this, this is how you vibrate higher. Remember the melting pot? I remember when I was a kid, that was always a thing. Like, this country's a melting pot. Sadly, we were so separated. When did that pot get thrown in the garbage? I don't know. When it comes to other cultures, oh, I love their food. I love their coffee. I love their music. And I'm a historian, so I love the history of everyone And I'm not talking about like Italians or the Jews or the Greeks. I'm talking about like just individuals. I love to sit somewhere. Like I will go to an Indian restaurant in downtown New Haven and get into an hour conversation with the owner about his life and what brought him to this country. And why does he own a restaurant? I recently met a guy who owned a company that makes some scenery for Broadway shows and plays and like Universal Studios. And my curiosity, I walked up to him. I said, why? Why did you do this? I'm fascinated by people. Vibrate love. And as a nation, as a planet, things will get better because we will vibrate higher. COVID sadly really caused such a tear in the fabric of this country. And I'm a true believer that it is in my blood to believe in us. We have recreated ourselves many times over. And there are those that long, sadly, for an apocalypse. That was mentioned in a recent podcast talking about how many times we've actually had an apocalypse, like this Thursday. Sadly, people talk about the planet disappearing, the planet blowing up. No, the planet's not going anywhere. The planet's been here for millions of years. We will. We are that little gnat riding on the top of this planet as it spins through space. Yes, we will probably disappear. And then a new group will come back. The planet is just going to keep rolling and rolling. We have a long way to go. Because if we believe in ourselves, know that love is stronger than hate. And there are so many things that truly unite us. Thank God for that. I have met so many racist people, and I mean racist, not like racist people, that will call others names, but love their food, love their music, and are even attracted to the, other races, men and women. So, are you that racist? Today's state of the world is a result of the collective consciousness of humanity. The current state of the world is a direct representation of the average vibration in which our humanity operates. Which currently right now, we have war, we have hunger, we have fear, we have violence, we have hatred, we have frustration. And conflict exists in the world because they are a part of the inner state of humanity. The media. I mean, do what you want. I'm not judging. I just do not watch news. I do not accept fear. I love the news, actually. I listen to it every day. Every morning I wake up and I turn on my Alexa and I ask it for news. And I pick and choose and I understand. And I know that most of it is bullshit. But it's okay. I need to know. I mean, even the weather is like a complete crock. But I follow through. My thing is, please, 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 question authority. But at the same time we experience growth, love, kindness, expansion, forgiveness, and change, there's always going to be negativity in the world. So you need to get smart. You need to learn to listen to that inner voice. That inner voice that you have has never let you down. Many of us has turned it off, which is, again, a last podcast. Well, that second to the last, I think. But this is exactly what is happening on Earth today. We're being bamboozled. And we need to be able to have faith in ourselves again, to believe in ourselves again. When you stop listening to the inner voice, what do you have? The people of social media? Their opinion? Sadly, you don't even know most of them. If you go to my Facebook, you realize I have quite a few friends. Facebook friends. As for true friends, I don't think it's ever gone past the number of fingers on one hand. True friends. As for the definition of true friends, I recommend when you finish with listening to me, Google it. What is the definition of a true friend? And then ask yourself, the people that you call friends, are they? Because here's the thing, you're vibrating. And if you attract shit over and over and over, and shitty girlfriends and shitty boyfriends and shitty opportunities and shitty jobs, and it's you. I ask that you take this time to look at yourself. Where do you think you vibrate? Do you feel light, energized, clear, and healthy? On the other hand, if you feel weighed down, repressed, oppressed, depressed, stuffy, heavy, you are most likely operating at a low vibration. And you can go out and you can buy the crystals and do all you think you know you're supposed to, but that's not going to help. You can go out and get a tarot reading and look for, you know, divination. That's not going to help. You need to cleanse yourself. You need to clear yourself. Look around your home right now. Is it filled with clutter? Is it filled with things that you, well, I have to do. I need to get to that. But you're not. Why? Because there's anchors holding you down. And guess what? Most of them, you threw them. And here you go, fast forward 5, 10 years later, and you're like, what the hell is happening to my life? You're the one who put the kibosh on it. You're the one who stopped it with your complaining, with your procrastination. Right now, as you're talking, well, listening to me, sorry, where are you? Physically, like, are you just like sitting somewhere and you haven't moved in like hours? Or are you at the gym listening to me in your ears? Are you in the car? Maybe going somewhere to do something, to accomplish something, to take on a task. The power is in your hands. The power is in your mind of what you want to do next. Are you going to do nothing? Well, that's fine. I mean, again, but just understand you will begin to vibrate lower. And when you do, you will attract garbage to your life. You will close doors. Actually, it'll get to the point no doors will come to you because they're not for you anymore. Because you would rather do nothing. And you gotta let shit go. I still meet people that I think is fascinating. They say that they're fine. They say everything is A-okay. And then I sit there and I'm not even doing hypnosis. I'm just doing some, you know, mindset coaching. And I start asking specific questions. And all of a sudden, shit comes up from junior year, from seventh grade. From that first job, from the thing that mommy said when they were 13. Understand, in most situations, the other person has moved on. And here you are still being held down by so many anchors. And because of this, you are probably not advancing as well as you wish you could. And then you're praying for abundance and no, it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. Yes, and I have... In many other episodes, including the last one, talked about taking ownership. If you want to vibrate higher, stop being a bitch. This path of darkness will not get you anywhere. Trust me, I speak from experience. I know how to be a bitch. And I get to witness it over and over again through my clients watching them. And I learn from them. This is why if you meet with me for a session, ever, whether it's over weight loss or smoking or whatever, I always want to know your whole story. People think that they're fat because they just can't stop eating or whatever it may be. No, my friend. Your canvas is not just a one-dimensional story, but it is more of like an onion with layer upon layer of so much pain, despair, sadness hidden in between the facade of happiness and joy. I love when people come in and they sit down and they're perky and happy. And it's almost like, why are you here? And they're like, I don't know. 20 minutes later, they're bawling. Sad. I will admit, when people come in and deny their misery, they don't realize the facade. And oh boy, they try. They try to be happy. But to me, the eyes say it all. As they say, the eyes are the windows to the universe, and for you, they are. And it's nice to see them finally crack, and you see a smile coming from their soul. It's such a beautiful thing. This is why I do what I do. It is so rewarding to see someone reset themselves. It is glorious. Now they are being true to themselves, and you see them control, alt, delete all of the baggage and bullshit from their past. You see them sever all their cords. You see them cut all of these chains from these anchors that have held them down, many that they did not even know were there. It's a beautiful thing. But it takes them, it takes you to want more for yourself, but willing to do the work to let go and to begin to know your true value. And when this occurs, this is when they have begun to learn to manipulate energy, starting deep inside. And then it happens all around them. The doors of opportunity open. This is when all of the shitty relationships just disappear. Without you even telling them to take a hike, you vibrate higher, and they will not want a part of it. This is why it seems when you get older, your true ring of friends gets smaller and smaller. Less quantity, more quality. It is amazing when you see it occur, but know it is for your betterment. So just take it all in. Be grateful and keep moving forward. If you're looking back and going, oh my God, you know, here I am at a certain age and I have no friends. I mean, the question then is, well, are they good friends or bad friends? Or were they not friends? They were just acquaintances. I am not one that, I know people that are still like, oh, do you still hang out with people from like seventh grade? I'm like, no, I'm a much different person. If we were to meet up again, we'd have zero to talk about. I'd rather put my energy towards the people that I surround me now. It's not hard as you think. So I cannot leave and end this show without like going over some steps of, well, how do I manipulate energy? How do I change myself? It is not as hard as you think. Step one, be present to ground your energy and focus on positive goals. A few weeks ago, I wasn't feeling really good. So you know what I actually did? I took my shoes off. I went outside and I walked in the grass. And the more I walked, the better I felt. I'm not one to walk barefoot. Kind of like, it's weird for me. Outside, I mean. But I did. And I felt like really good. It was crazy. Like I kept, like it was almost like a drug. I kept walking more and more because I was like, this feels great. I was grounding myself. But here you're grounding yourself with positive goals. You're focusing. Accept yourself for who you are and embrace the current moment and stay present and be realistic of your goals. Don't just make crazy shit up that you know as you're saying it, you're not going to do. Crawl before you can walk. Focus on what truly matters to you, whether that's your health, your family, your passions, or friendships. Start with little things. Little things. Manipulate little things. Make little things happen. When you meditate on what fulfills you, you'll ground and center yourself. And you become receptive to the world, and you become in control of your energy. When you're grounded, you're also more conscious or aware of yourself. So it's more intuitive and natural for you to direct your energy toward positive goals like creativity, connection, and self-growth. So get the fuck up and go do something with your life. Like, life is short, and this gift has been given to you to do things. Praying or meditating, whichever you wish. Pray to the universe so your energy invites in what you want. Scream from the rooftops what you want to manifest anything with your energy. Call out to any higher being you believe in. Ask for this sacred force to open your heart so your energy can flow freely and accept the presence of miracles. Dear universe, I am ready to accept my soulmate and a life full of passion. Nah, I can't find the right guy. God, I pray for wealth. I pray for health. So that I may be support and provide for my family. Nah, I can't get a real job. My life sucks. Higher power, please provide abundance so that I may thrive. I just can't catch a fucking break. See the difference there? Visualize your desire to shift your energy and attract positivity. Turn on relaxing music. Get in a comfortable position and close your eyes. Meditate on your most sincere wish. Try to play it out in your head like a movie scene. When you imagine that you already have what you want now, your energy flows toward the possibility to bring it to you. When you visualize, focus on all five senses. Here's the thing. Not just like, I want this. For the most immersive experience, focus on all five senses. For example, if you want to go on vacation, imagine what a beachside resort looks like, what the crashing waves sound like, what your comfy lounge chair feels like, and what your exquisite brunch smells and tastes like. It becomes. Use affirmations to ground your energy and feel self-acceptance. If you're anxious or nervous, your energy is probably scattered or fragmented. Yeah, if you're all over the place, scattered, and you need to focus, I'm sorry. If you're having 2 million thoughts a second, you got to learn to focus. And it's like, oh, but I can't. Figure it out. Everybody does at some point. You figure it out. The question is, how hungry are you? To get back in touch with your inner power and draw your energy back to your center, concentrate on loving yourself. A lot of times people don't want to go inward because they don't like the person that they see. Use affirmations to calm your heart, restore your self-esteem, and regain a sense of control. I am worthy of being cherished and valued. I am creative and enterprising. I'll find that perfect solution. I am fun and witty. I am amazing to be around. I am strong and resilient. I can overcome anything. Practice deep breathing to open your energy and accept your blessings. If you have a lot of energetic blocks, like pent-up anxiety or frustration, and you're running, oh my God, just stop. Tie yourself down to a chair. Then you may be closed off to higher frequencies of energy when you're racing around like that. Like love, gratitude, and miracles. You wouldn't even see the opportunities coming because you're so busy running around with like a chicken with its head cut off. Again, how bad do you want it? I come across so many people that tell me their plans, their goals, everything that they want to do in their lives. And I watch them. And then like a week goes by and I talk to them again. Same thing. And then a month goes by. A year goes by. And it is as if it was like a movie. It's just Groundhog Day all over again. The same conversation that I had with them 6 months ago. I'm not kidding. A year ago. They're repeating it as if I'm like, wait, did I? So since then, you haven't done shit? Like, it's amazing. Well, I have so much. No, nobody's that busy. You, I'm talking to you. You're not that busy. Nobody is that busy because here's the thing. The way the universe works is you don't make the time, life will stop for you and it will make the time for you. And as I've mentioned in many other shows, beep, beep, beep. Get used to it because that'll be the sound of you laying in a hospital bed. And at that point, it's magic how all of a sudden you don't have shit to do. You have no excuses. Yeah, there's no time to race around now. Why? Because when push comes to shove, life will stop. So I ask of you, you can dedicate. I actually just did a Monday morning mind's eye meditation. Go to my Facebook. Listen to it. Don't just pass by it. You can. It's 13 minutes. I mean, like three of them are me like doing the introduction, but I'm going to do one probably every Monday. I'll try. It's short. It's sweet. And I did it for people that are like, I can meditate. And then they can't even find my YouTube page. I have a YouTube page with like a lot of meditations. And people will ask me over and over, oh, do you have any meditations? Have you looked? Go to my YouTube page. But for now, go to my Facebook page. And there is one. It's a short one. It's a quickie. Just go. You sit down somewhere. You listen to it. Just please. And don't, like, if it doesn't, you know, if your mind is racing during it, it's okay. It's okay. It's your first time. But you need to do this for your health. And if you want abundance in your life, this is also the same thing. It's not coming. If you keep seeing, if you keep stepping in shit over and over and over, and I don't mean as a good way. I mean just like shit and just opportunities keep slamming in the face. And they're horrible opportunities. They're not like good, wonderful ones. And doors keep slamming and everything keeps happening. And oh my God, and I'm rising. And oh my God, and I'm going crazy. You better stop. You better stop. It's already been proven also by scientists. Stress kills. You'll get sick. And then that's when everybody does the whole, I wish I could have, should have. It's too late now. Let go of stuck energy that keeps you from being present and peaceful. Ground and center yourself by breathing deeply. Live for yourself. Live through yourself. Don't feel that you have to keep impressing people. get, excuse me for saying this, this is going to be rude, but honestly, get the fuck off of Facebook. Like, for a month. Stop trying to live your life how everybody else is living it. They did better than you. They have more than you. Yep, yep, they do. They worked for it. Or I don't care if they sold drugs for it. But the bottom line, this isn't about them. It's about you. Stop running and start focusing on your life. And when you do, you will vibrate higher. Don't just go through the steps and the manifestations and all this stuff. And, you know, and it's just, it's not the way it works. It's not the way it works. You have to feel it. You don't just read it. You don't just put pictures or vision boards on your board and on your wall and say, okay, it's going to happen. No, that's not the way it works. You have to, as I said, five senses. Five senses. That's when you connect with your five senses, the magic happens. I've been doing it for years, and as of recently, because I'm in this interesting place in my life, things are just dropping on my lap over and over and over. New opportunities, incredible people. I don't remember anything negative, and I'm grateful for it. And even if it does, here's the thing. It does happen, but it's a split second. I resolve it quickly. It's out of the way because I'm making too much time for the good. I don't have time for that shit. Sadly, we carry the energy of trauma and negative experiences on us. So as I'm saying, you have to ground yourself. You have to relax your muscles. You have to relax your mind. Do like I did a salt bath. Do a hike through the woods. And I mean, really. And like, I see people hiking. I just went hiking. And I see people hiking through the woods, and I hear music coming. And I'm like, what is this? And somebody walks by me with a radio. It's the woods. It's like, that's funny. I love the woods hiking so much that when I see that, I can't help but laugh. It's like, you know, the raccoons are like, shut that shit up. Do breathing exercises. Again, this is not a 40-hour thing. This is a 3-minute thing. When next time you sit on a toilet to poop, breathe. No phone in the bathroom. I know people have TVs in the bathroom. Just expel, release. Physically and mentally. You're in the bathroom for a few minutes? Perfect. Close the door. Shut out the world. I said, shut out the world. I have guided meditations on my YouTube page. Go through nuima.com. You could find them. They're free. I don't even charge for them. Listen to one. But actually, I highly recommend the Monday one. Because it's really short. I wanted to try to make something just, you know, about 10 minutes long. Not that involved. I was going to make one shorter, but no. I want you to get into it to some point. This is how you begin to welcome positive messages. And these block energies will break down. And you will begin to shift. And my friends, I mean this, you will eventually see a change. And I know if you follow these steps, you will begin to see major differences in your life. And this was episode 86, Manipulating Your Energy. Yesterday was my daughter's birthday. I want to wish her a very happy birthday. We went kayaking, see, connecting with nature. It was nice. It was up in Derby area. Like, I don't know, Lake Zor. And if you happen to go there, there's a hot dog stand, which I have driven by 30,000 times. I finally stopped. Well, because the kayak rental is right behind you. And if you go there, rent a kayak. It's $15 for an hour. It's all you need. It was phenomenal. It was great. We had such a great time. And then we went to Webb Mountain. And we did the fire thing. And we played. We threw a football. And we did all that fun stuff. We connected with nature. And I'll be honest with you. After being there for a few hours, it was tough for me to leave. It's like I become one with nature. And it's like, I don't want to leave. I really don't want to leave. Because the minute you pull out onto the street and you feel the buzz of the street lights again, it sucks. But you got, you know, it's what we do. So happy birthday, Kat. And thank you to everybody who, again, who's been listening. I greatly, greatly appreciate it. Remember, visit my Facebook or just go to my website. But on my Facebook page, all of them, is this Monday morning meditation. Listen to it. I hope you enjoy it. It'll take you to actually my YouTube page when you click on the link. Many, 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 many blessings to you all. I hope you're listening. Good night, Jack.
Brought to you by Nolima, Hypnosis and Healing and the Mind's Eye Meditation, and dedicated to all those that get up every day and hustle and do all they can to make a difference in their lives and the lives of others.